to Ray Farm Steam Academy's production of Annie Jr. This production is possible due to the incredible support of the Ray Farm Steam Academy PTA, the Ray Farm's Falcon Arts Booster, led by Tracy Renfro and Renee Schreiber, the Ray Farm's administration team, led by Brooke Huff, the custodial team, led by Anthony Strong, our incredible parent volunteers, our amazing cast and crew, led by our director, Susan Smith, and the production team of Mr. Booksparson, Mrs. Hoskins, and Mrs. Riley. And finally, an enormous thanks goes to you, the audience. We appreciate your support of the arts programs at Ray Farms and want you to have an amazing time. We ask that you take a moment to put your cell phones in airplane mode and then turn them off so you can fully enjoy this live theater experience. This will also help our sound system run smoothly, and we all want that. All photography and video during the production is strictly prohibited in violation of copyright law. Please refrain from talking during this production, but feel free to laugh and applaud with the performers to enjoy the show with them. Also, enjoy a 15-minute intermission where you can purchase refreshments. And certainly join us after the performance to greet the performers in the lobby. Children must remain in their seats and with their parents at all times. All aisles must remain clear as the performers will be using them during the show. If children become disruptive, please quietly exit the theater until they are ready to return. And remember, Miss Hannigan is watching. And now, Ray Farm Steam Academy's production of Annie Jr.
Thank you. He was riding on the ferry boat, and she was holding me up to see all the big ships, and then I couldn't find her no more.
It was only a dream, honey. Now go back to bed. It's after 3 o'clock.
Annie, bring me your note.
Again?
Please.
All right, Molly.
Here it comes again.
Oh, brother!
Please take good care of our little darling. Her name is Annie.
She's born on October 28th. We'll be back together soon.
She has the tab of a silver locket around her neck and kept the other half.
So that when we come back for her, you'll know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness, oh my goodness, now they're laughing.
All right, do you want to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Again. But you're lucky. You really got him.
I know. Somewhere.
Thank you.
1922. This is 1933. Now, for this one shenanigans, we'll all get down on your nubby little knees and clean this dust to recycle this off the Chrysler Building!
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning!
Get to work!
Yes, Miss Hannigan!
Why would any kid want to be an orphan? I'll never know.
Lucky duck, she goes.
Apples, apples, two for a pickle.
Excuse me, sir. Could you donate an apple to the orphan's picnic?
Why not? Nobody's buying them anyway.
Gee, thanks, mister.
Say, when is the orphan's picnic?
As soon as I take a bite.
You should have gone against Roosevelt.
Hey, listen to this. Herbert moved such a big interview. Why was in no way personally responsible for the 1929 stock market crash? I'm in the deepest sympathy for those not riding, hungry, and homeless.
Ragged!
Hungry!
Thank you.
really hope it's just a thin sweater. I hope it didn't catch influenza. Thank you so much again, officer.
It's all in the line of duty. And you, don't let me ever hear again that you run away from this nice lady.
Good afternoon, officer. And you, are you glad to be back, huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar! What's the one thing I always taught you never to tell a lie?
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yes?
I'm Grace Farrow, private secretary to Oliver Robux.
The Oliver Robux? The millionaire?
No, the billionaire. Miss Borux has decided to invite an orphan
for the Christmas holidays at his
home.
What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, capital M-I, double S-I, double S-I, double V-I, Mississippi.
And cheerful.
You, shut up. And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Say 8 or 9. 10, 11. Yes, 11 would be perfect. And, oh, I almost forgot. Mr. Wormus prefers brown-eyed children.
11? Brown-eyed? Sorry, we don't have any orphans like that here.
What about this child right here?
Oh, Annie, you know more than Annie.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
I would love to.
You can have any orphan here, but not Annie.
Perhaps I should call the Board of Orphans and...
If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you get.
It's Annie I want.
Oh, boy.
If you'll get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
She ain't got no coat.
Then we'll buy her one.
Oh, boy.
Come along, Annie. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is outside.
Oh, boy, I can hardly believe it.
She can hardly believe it?
Drink will bring your tray. When you're everyone.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
It's good to be home.
How was your flight from Chicago?
Not bad, 11 hours. Grace.
Yes, sir?
Messages?
President Roosevelt wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll get back to him tomorrow.
Mr. Warbucks.
All right, it's good to see you all again. Drake, staff.
Yes, sir.
And Grace, if you'll get your... What is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks, the orphan who will be with us for Christmas.
That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphans, so I chose a girl.
Well, I suppose you'll have to do. Anyhow, Annie, what?
It's just Annie, Mr. Warbucks, sir. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
Not at all. I couldn't be happier. Now, Grace, we'll start the iron ore shipments from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
It's her first night here, sir.
And well, Annie, I guess you'll have to do something special your first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gee, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
Fine. Then we'll go to the Roxy. Then an ice cream soda at Rumble Myers. And a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Golly!
Annie, forget the dictation. Grace, forget the dictation for tonight. You'll take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Oh, gee.
Something the matter, Annie?
It's just that I thought you were going to take me, Mr. Warbucks.
Oh, no, I'm afraid I'll be far too busy.
Aw, gee.
Now, Annie, I've just been away for 6 weeks. When a man is running a multi-billion-dollar corporation...
Oh, sure. I know. That's okay, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake?
Yes, sir?
Get our coats.
Leaping lizards!
Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Which collar are you wanting, sir?
The newsy bird. No way. This child's been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Walk? To the Roxy?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Smell those costumes. There's no air like the air in New York. Come on, someone. We got to get to the Roxy.
And
one,
two, three. The shimmer of Times Square. The folks.
The beach.
The drive. NYC. You might say that I'm square, but wow, I come alive.
The city's bright as a radio cave. It lifts, it tilts, it breaks.
Thank you.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove that just because a woman is 35 or more, romance and life need not be over.
God, I hope not.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? Waldorf's fed up with Annie already?
On the contrary. Miss Hannigan, this has to be signed and sent back to the Board of Orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that he wants to adopt her.
Annie? The daughter of a millionaire?
The daughter of a billionaire.
Would you excuse me for a moment, please?
Merry Christmas, Miss Hannigan.
Oops, pardon me, Blondie. Hi, sis. Long time no see.
Rooster? They finally let you out of prison? What were you doing for this time?
Some geezer said I swore to him $1,100.
Why do you say that?
Because the rooster swore to him out of $1,100.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine from...
Jersey City.
Rooster, do me a favor. Get out of here.
So who's the Blondie I bump into when I come in? Looked like she had a couple of dollars.
She will throw over Warbucks.
The Warbucks, the millionaire?
No, the billionaire. Andy, one of the orphans from here, is getting hits off to buy him.
From your orphan?
Yeah, living in the lap of luxury all the Hannigan kids and having the skids. It ain't fair how we scratch with your Warbucks while she gets Warbucks.
The little brat. It ain't fair if your life is driving me nuts while we get peanuts. She's living fat.
Maybe she's only keen a little lady
to get Warbucks
instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Give ya one guess.
Yes!
Easy three.
Yes, yes, Mr. President. No, I'm not asking for help. I'm just saying you need to do something about it. All right, talk about it on...
Friday.
Listen, Mr. President, why don't we bury that hatchet? And you, Mr. Roosevelt, come down for Christmas dinner. You will. Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace, find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany's?
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm going to give it to her and tell her I want to adopt her.
She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her
in.
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made a promise to myself. One day, somehow, I was going to be rich. Very rich.
That was a good idea.
But lately, I've realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you have no one to share your life with, If you're alone, you might as well be broke. I was in Tiffany's and got this for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks.
It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old one you were wearing, and I said, hey, I'm gonna get that kid a nice new locket. We'll just take this one
out. I don't want another one!
Annie, what's wrong?
This locket! My mom and dad gave it to me when they left me in the orphanage. And a note, too. I know I'm real lucky being here and all, but the one thing I always wanted in this world is to be like the other kids, with folks of my own.
It's all right. I'll find your parents for you.
Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father if he has to put everyone in his organization on the job, if he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up into including the White House. Annie, give me your locket.
But Mr. Warbucks?
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the FBI chasing for out who bought it.
Alright, well, I guess I'll give you my note later, too.
You wait, Annie. You may be meeting your mother and father within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh boy, I gotta write to the kids about this.
What a thing to walk her, finding them, losing them. For you won't be an orphan for long.
And pretty soon, we're going on the radio to tell them, okay? You gotta listen!
So maybe now it's time, and maybe when I wake, they'll be there calling me back.
Check of $50,000 to anyone who can prove they are Annie's parents.
Wow.
So, Annie's parents, if you listen in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall, another one of our Thursday night get-together has gone by fast, but you can say our turn. This is your old softie, Mrs. Healy's boy, Bert, saying, until next week, same time, same station, good night.
Healy saying,
$50,000 reward. $50,000! What can I do with $50,000?
Excuse us, ma'am, are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah, what do you want?
Ma'am, if you were looking here 11 years ago.
Yeah?
Well, we had terrible troubles back then and had to leave a baby on the front stoop.
A little girl, our Annie.
Your Annie's parents? I can't believe it. Where did you say you come from again?
A little farm up in Canada where they got lots of ducks and chickens and geese and roosters. Gotcha, sis.
Rooster, I would have never known it was you in 100 years.
Fool you, Aggie. We're gonna fool Wallbucks too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
We need your help, sis, for details about Annie that can help us pull this thing off.
What's in it for me?
Three-way split.
Half!
Okay, 25 grand each, but we gotta do it fast. Get the kid, get the money, and get out of town.
The kid's the problem. What will we do for afterward?
No problem. When I want someone to disappear, they disappear. For good. We get the 50 grand and we blow this crummy town. Little me will meet you.
Where? Oh, yeah!
Easy Street. Easy Street. Annie is the king.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Do you have those super documents I gave you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt
you. Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one else in the world I'd rather have a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. And you can have anyone in the world to come to. Now, who would you like?
Well, I guess I like Miss Peel here, and Mr. Drake, and Miss Peel, and well, everybody!
Drake.
Yes, sir.
Tell the staff to get Swiffy up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir. Yahoo!
Oh, and the kids.
It'll be past their bedtime by now, but I'll tell you what, tomorrow morning we'll have all the kids in the orphanage come down for the big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last. Together forever. We're tied up now. They never can sever. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue. I
Merry Christmas, Annie.
Earlier this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. He succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, Ronald and Shirley Mudge.
No, dear. David and Margaret Bennett.
But...
Annie, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
So you mean I really am an orphan, after all.
Annie, are you all right?
Yes, because I know that they loved me and that they would have came back for me.
I love you, Maggie Bennett.
I love you too, Mr. Warbucks. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could easily have been forged, but nobody knew about the locket except us.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, the children from the orphanage.
Hi, kids!
Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Same here. I know you anywhere.
Miss Hannigan, I'd like to introduce you to everyone. You know my private secretary, Miss Finn. And this is the President of the United States. And this is my brother, Drake.
Mr. Warbucks, this has just come from the FBI.
Now all fits together.
Ralph and Shirley Mudge.
Good morning.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas. Good morning. Well, we won't bother you on Christmas, Mom. We just come to pick up Annie.
Ah, yes, of course. The check. Here it is, Mr. Mudge. $50,000. Certified.
Certified. Paid to the order of... The jig is up?
Yes, the jig is up. Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dick.
Lewis, turn them over.
Yes, sir.
And I believe that you're quite not. This woman is their accomplice.
I've never seen these people till yesterday.
Come off it, Andy.
Andy, tell them I was going to make someone's list.
I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but what's the one thing you always taught me? Never to tell a lie.
Brat!
She made me do it! And Miss Hannigan is gone for good.
Hooray!
And you all don't have to work anymore. Yay!
Yes, girls, for you. And perhaps for all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. New deal. Oh, I like that.
So do I. A new deal. The sun will come out.